declaring the Lordship of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is the power unto salvation to them who believe. The Bible declares that there is no other name given whereby man must be saved but by the name of Jesus. The Bible also declares that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. It is through Him we live and move and have our being. Do you know Him? The Bible declares that if you believe with your heart that He was crucified, died, and was resurrected, and is now sitting at the right hand of God the Father, and if you repent of your sin, confessing with your mouth, you shall be saved, because Jesus Christ is Lord. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords, and we acknowledge His Lordship. He is a God who stepped out of nowhere and created everything, and coming from nowhere, He stood on nothing, because there was nothing for Him to stand on. He took something from nowhere and hung it on nothing, because there was nothing for Him to hang it on. And He told it to stay there, and it stayed there, and nobody said a word, because there was nobody to say a word. So God said, that's good. A thousand cattle on the hills belongs to Him. He don't need to put a brand on them. He is the owner. The song that the birds sung, He don't need a copyright. He is the owner. The earth belongs to Him. He don't need a wire fence. Somebody asks, where does God comes from? But God came from nowhere, and that is biblically and theologically correct, because the Bible, the book of Habakkuk chapter 3 verse 3 said that God came from Teman, and Teman meant nowhere. From generation to generation, He is Lord. He is the only omnipotent, mighty, and powerful God, the only omniscient, all-knowing God. He is the only omnipresent, the God of time and the God of space, and His presence is everywhere. The only immortal, the only wise, the only invisible God. He is the great I am that I am. He is El Shaddai, the Almighty God, the God who is more than enough, the God who is bigger and mightier and greater than all our situations and all our problems. He walks upon circumstances. He is above everything. The heaven declares His glory, and the earth showeth His handiwork. He stretched out the heavens like a curtain and weighed the mountains on scales. He gathered the dust of the earth as in a basket and hold the waters in the hollow of His hand. His limit is higher than the heaven and lower than the lowest hell, measure longer than the earth and wider than the sea. Do you know Him? He is wider than the wise, braver than the brave, and mightier than the mighty. There is none like Him, and none to compare to Him, none above Him and none beneath Him. Do you know Him? The heavens of the heavens cannot contain Him. Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord of the earth. He is Lord of the universe. He is more precious than diamond, worth more than gold, and nothing that we desire can be compared to him? Do you know him? To whom then can he be likened? Or to whom then can he be equal? Have you not heard? Have you not known the everlasting God, the creator of the heavens, neither faint or get weary? His understanding is unsearchable. He gave power to the weak, and to them that have no might, he gave them strength. Jesus Christ is Lord. He moves supremely. He showed no sign of fear. He was never in a hurry, and he met in no accident. He approached the cross with dignity and calmness and with assurance, and God fulfilled his promise, and one day he is coming again. Do you know him? Jesus Christ is Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and there is nothing made that were not made by him. In him was light, and the light was the light of men. Oh yes, he wrapped himself in light, and the darkness tried to hide and trembled at his feet. Yes, the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst men, and we beheld his glory, the glory of the Holy Begotten of the Father. His name is Jesus. Jesus Christ is Lord. Do you know him? Do you know him? If you don't know him, please don't turn him away. He came to save those who are lost. It is not his will that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Jesus Christ is Lord. Do you know him?